And to help all the home buyers and potential home buyers sift through some of the fine print here, we've brought in Mark Hansen from the IRS. Mark, appreciate you getting up with us here this morning. I want to talk first about this $8,000 first-time home buyer tax credit for 2009. In order to get the full amount, the full $8,000, what are the qualifications? There's fine print with everything.
Right. If you purchase the home this year, you may be entitled to $8,000. What you'll need to pay attention to is your income, though. If you're above a certain limit as an individual, that's $75,000. A married couple filing a joint return is $150,000. If you're above those income limits, then the amount of credit you might be entitled to would phase out, meaning it'd be reduced by however far you are above that income limit.
So you'd still get something. It just wouldn't be the $8,000.
That's correct.
Up to a certain point.
That's correct.
Alex Rodriguez would not be getting much if he bought a new house. Okay. What about for other things? What if you've owned property before? How do they define first-time home buyer?
Generally speaking, first-time home buyer, with the way this law is written, is somebody who has not been a home buyer for 3 years. Again, you're going to want to see how your specific facts and circumstances play into this. There is some additional paperwork you would attach to your federal income tax return. If you claim the money this year, it's Form 5405. It's newly updated on IRS.gov. You can take a look at it there. We also recommend that if you're a little concerned about the cumbersome paperwork, consider using electronic filing software, because that software will take care of the filing for you. Make sure you have all the proper documentation to support you taking that credit.
When there's thousands at stake, you want to make sure you get it right. What if you sell your house? What if you take the money and then for some reason you have to move, you can't make the payments, you have to sell the house later? What happens to the credit then?
If you sell the home within 3 years, then you have to pay back that tax credit.
Ooh,
the important
okay.
thing to remember from the previous credit, though, that was passed last time around, was it was up to $7,500. You paid that back over a 15-year period. Now, if you purchase the home this year, as the law is written right now, between January 1st and December 1st,
I believe it is,
then
right.
you can keep the money as long as you stay in that home for 3 years.
This year it's a loan. For last year's folks, it is not. It is a loan.
Well, for last year, if you closed on that home before December 31st of last year,
right.
then it would still, as the law is currently written, I'll emphasize that, as the law is currently written by Congress and signed by the President, you would have to pay that back over a 15-year period. If you purchase the home this year, then it's $8,000 that you can keep if you stay in the home.
More incentive to buy. Mark Hansen, we appreciate your time here this morning. I'm sure you'll be stopping by again between now and April 15th, as always. Thank you.